Hello, doTERRA friends, and welcome to another edition of Oil Talk. I'm your host, Scott Johnson, and as always, it's my pleasure to have another opportunity to discuss our amazing doTERRA products. Today, I've invited a special guest and a member of the doTERRA Medical Advisory Board, Dr. Paul Winterton. Dr. Winterton is a board-certified orthopedic surgeon and strong proponent of essential oils and dietary supplements. I'm always excited when I connect with a Western-trained physician that integrates natural solutions into his or her practice. So I am thrilled Dr. Winterton made time in his busy schedule to talk to us today. Welcome, Dr. Winterton.
Thanks for having me, Scott, and I'm excited to share what I know today.
Now, today's topic centers around an important body function, namely breathing. The respiratory system is responsible for the intake of oxygen to deliver it to cells and organs so they work efficiently. Another important task it performs is to clear waste gases, like helping us get rid of carbon dioxide. It is also important for sensing odors and aid speech. Our airways and respiratory system are challenged each day by irritants, environmental materials, and other substances. Now, as we were talking casually, I found it interesting that you regularly help your patients with airway challenges, particularly since most people assume your whole focus as an orthopedic surgeon is on the musculoskeletal system. Tell us a little bit more about this.
Well, as a physician and surgeon, I'm in daily consultation with my patients regarding concerns they have about airway discomfort at the time of surgery, as well as other respiratory irritation they may experience during the changing seasons. This is in addition to living along the Wasatch Front mountain range here in Utah, where one of the world's greatest temperature inversions causes massive annual collections of particulate irritants that settle in the valley.
As a longtime resident of the Wasatch Front, I can certainly attest to this. We are surrounded by mountains that act like a bowl to trap ozone and other pollutants in the valley. This is when we really hope for a good storm to blow the dirty air out of the area and give our respiratory system a break. You also mentioned airway challenges your patients experience during surgery.
That's right, Scott. Regarding activities in the operating room, particularly when a patient is quietly unconscious during the operation, of course, under the watchful eye of the anesthesiologist, a lot of activity is happening in the airways of the person having the surgery. When a patient arrives in the operating room, they've been given a sedative immediately prior, which aids in the process of anesthesia induction. Intravenous medicine is given first, followed by placement of the plastic and rubber tubing in the proximity of the airway, or sometimes inserted directly into the airway. This mechanical tubing can cause abrasion as well as irritation from static pressure throughout the duration of the operation. Anesthesia is then administered with gas that maintains this unconscious state for the duration of the operation, which can sometimes last for hours. And although we may try and keep the air moisturized that's flowing from the anesthesia machinery into the lungs, the positive pressure of the oxygen and nitrogen administered can be quite an irritant to the entire airway of the lungs. Of course, at the completion of the operation, the mechanical tubing is carefully removed as the patient starts to breathe on their own. Of course, coughing and gagging is inevitable during this process as the natural reflex to purge the collective phlegm occurs. Understanding this process of anesthetic airway management, it should come as no surprise that the airway can remain significantly irritated for many days, actually, following surgery.
The way you describe it helps us who have only been the unconscious person better understand how irritated airways can become following surgery. What's the approach to handle this post-op?
So traditional bronchial dilators are sometimes prescribed by the doctor. Patients can also access the wonderful soothing effects of natural resources such as lemon, lavender, and peppermint, all three of which have been utilized for centuries as a way to provide calming relief for the respiratory system. My patients enjoy doTERRA Tri-E soft gels that contain peppermint, lavender, and lemon. Given in the post-anesthesia care unit, also known as the PACU, doTERRA Tri-E soft gels can be a wonderful adjunct to the routine surgical recovery experience.
I really hope our physician friends are listening to this, because I think this is a great way to complement standard care following surgery, which may improve patient comfort, experience, and outcomes. What about the environmental challenges to airways, particularly when the seasons change?
Well, that's right. Just as anesthesia and surgery can irritate the upper airways, particulate matter and pollen in the air can be a great source of discomfort for my patients. The annual temperature inversion that gathers and concentrates air particles and other substances into the valleys along the Utah Wasatch Front mountain range is an example of this. Patients that have hypersensitive upper airways, or the elderly population that have compromised lung function, are profoundly vulnerable to these irritants. This air pollution and seasonal release of pollen are challenging for our patients that are medically infirm or simply have hypersensitive airways. My patients are so grateful for access to doTERRA Tri-E's as a complementary support to their traditional medical regimen. Much has been published citing the soothing effects that peppermint, lavender, and lemon, with people around the world likewise reporting the wonderful benefits of Tri-E's. This remarkable supplement was designed to support healthy respiratory function when needed most.
I love to introduce people to essential oils with peppermint oil by having them place a drop or two on their palms, rubbing their hands together, and then cupping their palms over their nose and mouth to inhale. This is a very pleasant experience. I understand there is also research that supports ingesting peppermint to support healthy respiratory function.
That's right, Scott. Researchers found that ingestion of peppermint oil supported healthy respiratory function in male college students. Basically, they had feelings of clearer airways and easier breathing. Limonene is the primary constituent in lemon oil. Preclinical research shows that limonene may help relax the airways and support healthy lung and immune function. But more research needs to be done to confirm these conclusions. Now, going on to lavender essential oil, this is rich in linalool, which experimental research shows may support healthy immune responses, again, with follow-up research needed. This is important since it's our own immune system that responds to the nasty stuff in the air and mounts a defense against it. Together, these three essential oils are great for people who want to spend more time enjoying the changing seasons.
I completely agree. I know that two of my children use Tri-E's regularly, and they don't want us to ever run out. And they are so simple to use. Simply take 1 to 2 soft gels per day. I want to thank you again, Dr. Winterton, for taking time to talk to us about this important product. I know how busy you are.
It's been my pleasure, Scott. Thanks again for having me. I always love talking about these kinds of things.
I'm sure that many of you have thought of people who could benefit from this information and Tri-E's. So make sure you share the video with others. We thank you for joining us today. Until next time, we wish you health and happiness.